Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Solland Reloaded on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Solland Reloaded and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Solland Reloaded. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else my friends, to get started we need to open our main internet browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL that I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type that URL, because I added a clickable link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We ended up at this point on our site of Usitility, where we find here a precise explanation on the best way to download and install Solland Reloaded on computer. We search lower a bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on that link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will load to get access to the game Solland Reloaded on the PC. It is now obvious that we get a number of pros of preferring this emulator. So we are on the way to proceed to download the Solland Reloaded by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. We then click on the button. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It is a file we have to execute. What we have to do now is to launch the executable file, okay, so we have to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I minimize the web browser to see the installation software much better. The installation software is very easy to use. It consists of a couple of options, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path really does. We simply click on it. And so we realize that we have here the path where the emulator will be set up. If we prefer to modify this folder we are required to click on this browse option, and we pick another folder and install the emulator where we prefer. I will leave it where it is. Then, I click on back. Therefore I just click on install. Fantastic! The install starts and it is going to continue in the download of those megabytes that happens to be shown on that computer screen. When you download it, it could possibly be a little more or less megabytes. The download rate could go faster or at a lower speed, subject to your web access and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. At the moment they are going superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator has actually been launched successfully. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar which will advance to the right and once it gets into the end, the emulator is started for the very first time. The fact is that the emulator is already launched there for the first time. Before we keep going, as can be seen, it has created a couple of icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is going to be the only one we are concerned with. Whenever we have to launch Solland Reloaded on our PC, we twice click this app icon and consequently launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me make the next step, which is actually a must, and this is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we are going to mouse click on Play Store. As you understand the Google Play is presented. Here we are required to sign in. Currently the moment we are on this page, we must execute this next step that is definitely absolutely mandatory. Therefore we just click on Sign In. At present it announces Checking Info. It can once in a while get stuck in Checking Info, that's why it isn't going to move ahead. In this case, you should try to connect to your account after a few hours it's going to quite likely be repaired. At present we can enter our email address and password. The email address ought to be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For instance you can utilize the same email address you use at the moment in your YouTube account. So that I am going to enter my details and I'll come back when I have accomplished it. Voila, information entered. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us their twos. We will say yes to them all simply by pressing, I agree. Then, it allow us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it selected it's going to produce a backup of your files on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is started by default and completely on its own. To install the application, we have got to visit the emulator desktop for Android by double-clicking on that app icon marked green-colored. At this point that we are exploring the desktop of the emulator for Android, we see that we find right here the install video game option. We click or double-click on that button. On this page we come with the game. Let's click on Now on the Install link that I am presenting now in green color. This action will launch the installation. Presently it will install the video game, it can take a bit of time or it might well be very fast. That all is going to depend on the internet connection. It's as of now finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this option that I am emphasizing in green, so that you can run Soland Reloaded for the very first time. You are presently on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're going to just click that new Soland Reloaded software icon which was generated. Your Android game is launched for the first time on your computer. There we end up with it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to talk about the volume of that emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of this emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the fullest, we will turn on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This one is simply the first one, we then click on this app icon which I am actually designating in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, having one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. If ever we choose to appreciate the application in full screen, we hit this particular app icon. And we'd already be experiencing and enjoying the game in 100% screen setting. To leave the complete screen functionality, click the F11 key. And so we would definitely already play in normal display screen setting. At this point, I am on the way to reveal you the computer keys mapping which is certainly quite exciting. That step we may be in a position to use the game app a lot more easily. The first point is to click this keyboard icon. And at this time there you will have the ability to make the recommended configurations. I'll go ahead and put the default settings, though if you wish to adjust it, you can easily do it now with no problem. Clearly, the emulator is fully in our language. On occasion it happens that your emulator is started in the incorrect language, such as, in Mandarin. And so to set it up in the right language we go there to the cogwheel. And thus right here within many other settings, we just click the language drop down. We can easily opt for the language we need, German, Japanese, and so on. Once the language is decided, we could save, the emulator would restart, and also the game app, the next time we use it, will also be in the opted for language. Presently, you will find another detail that we have to take into account, and this is that we will get a message from Gmail telling you that a different machine has been associated with our Google account. It definitely will question us if we are the ones who have associated with that device. Yes, we may not get worried, since the emulator is simulating in Google Android device. And in order to determine which device is currently being emulated, we arrive right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Be sure you browse here to the model option. And now we discover that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for the video user demo. I hope you appreciated it, specifically that you thought it was interesting. In that case, allow it a good thumb up, subscribe, and any comments, issues or suggestions, leave them in the comment area down below. You may also leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams from time to time, you get it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of the training videos that are appearing on the screen and see you in the following videos. Bye.